Hello everyone. Today we're going to look at how to make a glowing 3D sculpture like this with a 3D pen. 3D pens use the same kind of plastic and filament as regular 3D printers. I guess it just has a bit more of a personal touch, and it's just a little bit more sloppy because you're holding the little plastic dispenser thing in your hand instead of it all being applied with computerized precision. There seem to be two major types of filament you can use. ABS or PLA plastic. I'm using PLA plastic here because according to my research, it's safer to use indoors without a whole bunch of ventilation. And on the plus side, it smells sweet, like candy when you use it. And I'm not going to complain about that, am I? I didn't do a whole lot of research before I bought this pen. It was just one of the ones that had a bunch of good reviews on Amazon, because that's just how I buy things. It was about $70, and I bought two big spools of the plastic filament to build things with. Doodle in 3D space, which are about $15 or $20 each. You can get all sorts of crazy colors, pretty much any color you can imagine, even clear filament and filament that glows in UV light, which maybe I should try sometime. But really, for now, for starting out, I just wanted to have a whole lot of the stuff, and I didn't want to have to worry about running out of it. You know, that's a bad feeling when you're making things. When you're using art supplies, in the back of your head, you don't want to have to worry about running out of it. Anyway, so I have plenty of it. These spools are actually meant to be attached to the sides of 3D printers, I think, on like a little peg, a little spoke, and then it feeds into the 3D printer automatically. Anyways, I would just cut off little sections of it, and it feeds into the back of the 3D pen automatically. I probably mentioned this in the previous video I did with the 3D pen, but I was very reluctant to get one of these, just because I figured the longer I wait to get one of these, kind of, this is the same way I feel about the whole, what's it called, VR, like the VR drawing. The longer I wait, two things will happen to get one. The longer I wait, first of all, the better the technology will get, and the cheaper the technology will get. But I'd already waited a long time, and I could tell the technology was getting better because the pens were getting slimmer. These things used to be big. They were intimidating to hold, like the size of like a large, like a big raw cheddar brat, and I wasn't really interested in that. But now these things are barely larger than like a regular size pen or a marker. Now, I was live streaming while I was doing this, and a lot of people were hitting me with all sorts of crazy ideas, and other people mentioned to me other ideas, and I've thought of some on my own, of course. And of course, there are all sorts of applications, like you can make, you know, like something like a cup holder. But you can also make things to wear, I think. The only thing is, like, if you want to make, like, a glove or a hat, you don't want to apply this stuff straight to your skin because it comes out at about 200 degrees Celsius, which is some larger number in Fahrenheit, of course. But if you wear, like, some sort of skin-tight leather or some, I don't know, you could probably get, like, a mannequin head and build a hat around a mannequin head, which I might try sometime. That would be cool. I think you could make a sweet, like, a really cool helmet or a hat or a mask with this, or cool, like, armor. That would be sweet. Maybe I should have done that this time, but sometimes, also I forgot to mention this, I didn't really set out to make a quote-unquote lamp or a lit sculpture when I started this. I just started, which is what I usually do. I just started, and about halfway through this, I thought, hey, I could put lights in this thing, and maybe it would look really cool if it was lit up from the inside. Throughout the process of making it, every now and then I would stick a light bulb inside of it and see what it looked like, and it looked pretty cool with a light bulb, but I wanted to have it just battery powered so I could put it out there by itself and not have like a cable or a cord running out to it. But it does look cool with a light bulb. It looks cool even just lit from a light bulb, just very closely from the side, because of all the weird contrasty shadows cast all across it. And a lot of people wonder this, despite maybe how it looks with all these weird skinny little strands of plastic. First of all, it is not very heavy. I should probably weigh it. I don't have like a very sensitive scale, but it's not heavy at all. And it does feel very sturdy. Like I could squeeze it pretty hard from like every direction, and it flexes a tiny bit, but it doesn't feel like it's about to break. I never while holding it did I feel like it was about to break. In fact, it's very hard to break like the little strands off. I had a little scissors from my Letterman there, and I'd use those to snip off little bits that I didn't want. And that's pretty much, if you make mistakes, you can just kind of snip off pieces with scissors, or I guess you could use like an angle grinder, you know, if you wanted to just lop off a whole chunk, or I don't know, whatever you want to do. Anyways, I'd recommend it to anyone if you have a few dollars to drop on a weird, new, kind of quirky piece of technology for making 3D art. You can also, of course, just go the old-fashioned route if you want to make 3D art and just grab a lump of clay. I mean, so I'm not saying 3D art is some new-fangled thing. It's been around for a long time. Sculptures are not new. Lamps are not new. But this is a fun way to do it, and there's not too much of a learning curve. Just grab it, get some filament, start messing around with it, and before too long, you'll get the hang of it. And the main thing I didn't like about this was all the weird little wispy strings you get. But it's really not the end of the world. It's just, like I always say, you can get used to anything. But anyways, let me know if you have any questions in the comments or suggestions of maybe what I should try to make in the future. I'll try to reply to as many as I can. Does anyone else notice that YouTube seems to be, like, broken for the past few years? Like, if you're on the computer, you can't, like, mention people in comments. It only works on the phone, maybe? I don't know. YouTube seems to be getting worse and worse with everything they change. Anyways, that's different. It's a different thing. Anyways, goodbye, everyone. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.